السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today inshallah we start lesson 2. Last time we revised the letters, the alphabet. Today we make revision again, but from Nur al-Bayan book. Just to know that sometimes the alif is written with hamza on the top, and sometimes it's written without alif, without hamza. So I will start. Alif, ba, ta, sa. جيم ح خ دال ذال را زاي سين شين صاد ضاد طا ظا عين غين فا قاف كاف لام ميم نون ها واو همزة يا. Also we talked about the heavy letters, that some letters we have to pronounce it with full mouth, like the خ, the صاد, the ضاد, the طا, ظا, the غين, the قاف. So these letters we have to pronounce it with full mouth, and we said this last time that the ulama put it in this phrase خص ضغط قذ, and to pronounce it heavy or with تفخيم you have to raise the deepest part of the tongue and push the pressure of the sound to the roof of the mouth. And sometimes the ra, inshallah, we know the rules of the ra later. Sometimes you pronounce it heavy and sometimes you pronounce it light. Then inshallah, we'll talk about the letters that could be, you think that it has the same sound or something, but they are completely different. So the dad and dal. The dal, very light. The dad, heavy. But the dal from the tip of the tongue with the gum line. The dot from the sides or the edges of the tongue. So the position or the pressure of the letter is not the same. If you try to press on the tip, it will give you heavy dal, but not the right letter or the dot. The va, dal, and zay. The va and dal, you have to pronounce it with the tip of the tongue touching the tip of the two front teeth. The zay, it's deeper little, it's like zoo or z, we pronounce it like z sound. And of course the dha is heavy, the dhal is still light, but from the same point. Inshallah we study the articulation point in book 2, inshallah after we finish this book. Saad and seen, both of them also from the same point, the tip of the tongue. But the saad heavy, the seen light. When I say saw, not like sa. How? Like we said before, where the deepest part of the tongue or inside, most of the tongue is raised to the roof and imprison this whole sound inside. I say saw, not sa, like push it out. Ta and ta. The ta and ta from the same point, the same articulation point. But the ta, heavy, has tafkhim. I have to raise all my tongue to the roof and imprison the sound. Ta. But the ta, I push it out. Thal and tha. Thal, in English, is the same two letters, the th, but in Arabic, this is as in that, and the tha as in three. Even remember, if you see the three dots, that remember number three. Then, this is quick review about the letters, how these letters looks like in Mus'haf or in any Arabic word, if you join them together, how these letters looks like if it comes at the beginning of the word or in the middle or at the end. So if we talked about the alif without hamza, the alif without hamza never come at the beginning of the word because it will be like mad letter must preceded by fatha or any letter with fatha, so it never come at the beginning. the alif in the middle, you could attach it to the previous and the at the end is the same, but you can't attach it to the following letter. Also, if you notice that I put the letter that you could attach it with the previous letter, not the following, I put it in blue shade. So you know that these six letter, all these six letter, you attach it to the previous letter, not to the following. The alif, the dal, the dal, ra, zay, and the waw. The other letters, it could be attached to the previous or to the following in the middle like this. Or like these letters. So inshallah, study the shape carefully to know how these letters looks like in Mus'haf. At the end of the word for the ta and ha, there's different shape. It could be normal ta, or we call it ta mabsuta, the opened one, or closed ta, and we call it ta marbuta. The ta marbuta also has two shapes due to the previous letter. If the previous letter from the six letter that you can't attach it to the following, so you use the circle one for the ta and for the ha. If it's normal letter like other letters that you could attach it to the letter that comes after, you will use this shape. So inshallah, this chart just practice how to read them properly or write down how the letter looks like. The same pages, you will find it in Nur al-Bayan book with bigger size. So inshallah, practice them. Then we will talk about the harakat. After we know the name of the letters, this called ba, this called sin, we can't pronounce it like this. We pronounce it the sound of the letter. And to pronounce it the sound, there is three different harakat that you have to put on the letter in Arabic. The harakat, this is the plural, and the singular is haraka. Haraka means the time that you take to pronounce one letter with this haraka. So the three different harakat for the short sound is called fatha, dhamma, and kasra. The fatha, and the name, the word fatha means in Arabic to open, because you have to pronounce it with opened mouth. So when you pronounce any letter with fatha, you have to open your mouth, a proper opening, not to the side, not with a smile. And if the letter heavy or light, no difference. I don't want you to narrow your lips when you pronounce it the heavy letters and smile when you pronounce it the light letters. This is from mistakes. And of course, when you pronounce the letter with tarqiq letters, so you don't raise anything from your tongue. But if you pronounce the tafkhim letters, you have to raise your tongue. So after we know the fatha, this is from the beginning, we start to read the letters with fatha. So I will read how to say the spelling. Alif, hamza, fatha, a. ب فتحة ب ت فتحة ت ث فتحة ث جيم فتحة ج ح فتحة ح خ فتحة خ دال فتحة د ذال فتحة ذ ث فتحة ث ت فتحة ت ب فتحة ب ألف همزة فتحة أ خ فتحة خ جيم فتحة ج ح فتحة ح ذال فتحة ذ دال فتحة د ث فتحة ث ح فتحة ح. Of course, there is lots of exercise in this book. I put it to make sure that you practice well how to read all these letters. So the same letter and the order is it's not in the same order, to practice how to know the letters without thinking about the order and repeat the order without knowing the right letters or not. So we continue. Ra fatha ra, zay fatha za, seen fatha sa. So the name of the letter seen, but the sound when you put the fatha become sa. The same with sheen, fatha sha. صاد فتحة صا، ضاد فتحة ضا، طا فتحة طا، ظا فتحة ظا، عين فتحة ع، جيم فتحة ج، ب فتحة ب، خ فتحة خ، ت فتحة ت، ح فتحة ح، ث فتحة ث، ألف همزة فتحة أ، ذال فتحة ذ، دال فتحة د، زاي فتحة ز. The letter زاي I could say it زاي or ز. The both are right. را فتحة را، شين فتحة ش، سين فتحة س، ضاد فتحة ض، صاد فتحة ص، ظا فتحة ظ، طا فتحة ط، زاي فتحة ز، دال فتحة د، ذال فتحة ذ، را فتحة را. Okay. This is the same. This is page number 3. Of course, the people who know these things or basic things, they could skip this part and move to the next part. But this is for the beginner. غين فتحة غا، ف فتحة ف، ق فتحة ق، ك فتحة ك، لام فتحة ل، ميم فتحة م، نون فتحة ن، واو فتحة و، ها فتحة ه، يا فتحة ي، عين فتحة ع، ظ فتحة ظ، ط فتحة ط، سين فتحة س، ضاد فتحة ض، شين فتحة ش، صاد فتحة ص، زاي فتحة ز، را فتحة را، ذال فتحة ذ، دال فتحة د، ألف همزة فتحة أ، ب فتحة ب، جيم فتحة ج، خ فتحة خ، ث فتحة ث، ت فتحة ت، ح فتحة ح، ي فتحة ي، ك فتحة ك. And this is again the letter how it looks like in the middle of the word at the beginning or at the end. Also study them well inshallah from Nur al-Bayan book. Then this is the letter that has similar shape or how it's written with the same way but they are different. So you have to differentiate between the ba and noon. The ba, the dot not on the top, it's below the letter, the noon on the top. The ta and ya is the same, but the ta has the two dots on the top, the ya under the letter. The tha and sheen, also take care of the tha and sheen shape. The jim and ha, the zay and ra, zal and dal, one with dot, the other one without dot. Dad and sad, also the dad with dot, the sad without. Va and ta. Ghain and Ayn, the Ghain with dot, the Ayn without. Sheen and Seen. Fa and Qaf, the Fa has one dot, the Qaf has two dots. The same thing, the Fa, some people mix between the Fa and the Ghain. So take care of this also. The Fa is like has a small circle or hole in the middle, the Ghain not. The Lam and Kaf. The ta and ha, if there is two dots, it's ta, if there is no dots, it's ha. And then the hamza and the lam. We said the hamza, you could attach it to the previous letter, but not to the following. So if you found the lam attached to the following, it means it's not alif hamza. The ayn and ghain, the closed ta and ha, noon and thal. The noon, you could attach it to the word, but the thal, you can't attach it to the following word. The fa and ghain, the ayn and ghain, the hamza and ayn. And this is the letters that could have the same sound. So the qaf and kaf, you have to differentiate that the qaf is heavy, qa qa, the kaf light, qa ka, za za, tha س ظ ذ ت د ض د س ص ف ث ط ت ل ر ظ ز غ خ ع ح ا ه ذ ث ه ح. So after you practice inshallah with these letters, I hope inshallah you practice and read them properly, and to make sure that you pronounce them right or not, you listen to the video again to see if you pronounce them with the right way or not. Next inshallah we start to read the words that has fatha and how to spell the whole words inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.